Hello everyone, welcome to Biomedical in EE seminar series. I'm Youngkyu Yoon, an assistant professor of electrical engineering at KAIST. I would like to share some of the recent progress from our lab, and the title of the seminar is Optical and Computing Technologies for Data-Driven Neuroscience. As you can infer from my affiliation, which is the School of Electrical Engineering, I'm an engineer, not a scientist. Nevertheless, I would like to start with talking a little bit about science. Science is about understanding phenomena based on empirical evidence. And advancing scientific knowledge is based on the following process. We start with making an observation, and then we propose a hypothesis that explains the observation. And then we design and perform the experiments to verify the hypothesis. In this process, driving a hypothesis from the observation is often the key step, and this step relies highly on human intuition. For example, Isaac Newton hypothesized the law of gravitation from his observation on the motion of the moon and the motion of freely falling objects on Earth. He thought those two are basically the same phenomenon that could be explained with the law of gravitation, which is a great intuition. So as you can see, discovering this simple law took such a great intuition. Then we may ask ourselves, how can he possibly come up with a good hypothesis for a system that is too complicated and beyond human intuition? One possible solution could be, we can take a big data and let the computer analyze it to find the rules, which is kind of what we are already doing a lot with machine learning. To do that, we need technologies to acquire big data, and we also need algorithms to analyze the big data. Now, let's think about applying this to understand the brain. A human brain is an incredibly complicated system with about 100 billion neurons and 100 trillion synapses. So neuroscience might be the right place to take a data-driven approach. For that, we need technologies to acquire big data from the brain, and we also need algorithms to analyze the big data from the brain. And that is exactly what our group is working on. On the acquiring the big data side, we are developing technologies to image brain activity of large number of neurons. And we are also working on technologies to simultaneously image various proteins in a brain tissue. On the analyzing side, we develop algorithms to automatically process the brain activity image data to extract the signal from each neuron. And then we apply data mining to it to find the underlying patterns in brain activity. Here we have some visual examples. The video on the left shows the brain activity of a small fish. Using our technology, we image the brain activity in 3D at high speed and then at single neuron resolution. The image on the right is an image processing outcome from such data. We devised a neural network that can automatically segment all the neurons in the video, which does not require any training data. Okay, let me go into a little bit more detail about imaging brain activity. Light field microscopy is a technique for capturing 3D information in a 2D image, which can be computationally processed to restore the 3D volume. We decided to apply and advance this technique for capturing the brain activity, and that is because this approach allows us to perform 3D imaging at the speed of the camera, which can easily go beyond 50 Hz, whereas other competing methods could only go about a few Hz. So, here's an overview of how it works. This is an image of a tiny fish called zebrafish, which is genetically modified so that its brain glows in green, and each neuron gets brighter whenever it fires an electrical pulse called action potential. We image this fish brain using light field microscope, and the raw image contains multiple projections of the fish brain in different angles. And then, we can computationally combine those projections to reconstruct a 3D volume. Using this system, we can capture the images as fast as we want and computationally reconstruct the volume later. And thanks to this operation principle, we were able to achieve an order of magnitude speed improvement compared to other methods. And here's an example video of the fish brain. You can actually see the neurons blinking here and there, which correspond to neuronal activity. We were able to image the brain activity at extremely high speed, in this case at up to 50 Hz, but the price we had to pay was the decrease in resolution. And this is because the amount of information that can be captured in a camera is limited by the number of pixels on it. In other words, the volume reconstruction is numerically ill-posed, hence the resolution is limited. Therefore, we wanted to find a solution to solve this problem. And the solution we found was inspired by the super-resolution microscopy method that won Nobel Prize in Chemistry in 2014. The main idea of super-resolution microscopy is that if you can image only a small portion of the object in each frame, you can accurately find the location of their centers even if the image looks very blurry. And we can collect those center locations to construct a super-resolution image. So we took this idea and used for brain imaging as follows. Neuronal activity is sparse in spatial and temporal domains. That means, if we can decompose only the active neurons from the video, which we can do by solving this optimization problem, there will be only a small number of neurons in each frame. Then, for each frame, we can find the accurate location of each neuron, which means we can obtain high-resolution 3D volumes. And here's a video of the fish brain obtained with our method. Again, we can see the neurons blinking here and there, which correspond to neuronal activity. But this time, we were able to get much better resolution, and we can clearly see the neuronal activity at single-cell level. And here's a comparison of the earlier method and the new method. This is the resolution we were getting from a zebrafish brain with the method reported in 2017. And in comparison, this is what we could get with our method. We can actually see not just the cell bodies, but also the fine processes thanks to the resolution improvement. Now, let me switch the gear a little bit and talk more about analysis. The imaging method that we just talked about requires decomposing only the neuronal activity from the video, and that requires solving this optimization problem. And solving this optimization problem using conventional method becomes very challenging when you have to deal with extremely large data. And that is because we have to store entire data on the RAM, and we need to perform singular value decomposition multiple times, which is computationally very expensive. So we came up with a new approach. Basically, we developed a new method that can solve almost the equivalent problem, but however, our network does not require any training data, it is order of magnitude faster, and it is capable of handling extremely large data. Here on the right, you can see that the network is perfectly capable of decomposing the activity from the video. So the video on the left is the raw input, and the video on the right is the decomposed activity. And as you can see on the top right, we can apply the same algorithm to a video from a surveillance camera, which might help you see what the algorithm is actually doing. And later, we found that the same method can be extended further. We can cascade two networks, whereas the first network performs the sparse decomposition, and the second network can further process the activity of the neurons and automatically segment the neurons and the video. The important thing is, just like the previous example, this network does not require any training data, it is very fast, and it can handle extremely large data. So far, I have introduced one method for acquiring big data from the brain and one method for analyzing big data from the brain. And I would like to briefly introduce other research topics that we are working on in the context of acquiring and analyzing big data from the brain. With Professor Zhang, we are developing ultra-multiplexed imaging method which allows us to image more than 15 proteins in a single round of imaging. And we are working on next-generation 3D microscopy method for high-speed brain activity imaging. We are also developing AI-assisted microscopy method, and in this particular example, we took only two images of a tiny worm called C. elegans, and the network reconstructed the entire volume using the two images. And lastly, with Professor Shin, we are implementing a pipeline to do data mining from the brain activity to find the underlying patterns. So, let me finish with concluding remarks. Understanding a brain, which is an extremely complicated system, may benefit from data-driven approaches. And for data-driven neuroscience, we need technologies for acquiring and analyzing big data from the brain. And for that, we are developing various optical and computational methods. All right, that's it for this video, and I hope you enjoyed watching it. And please check out the other videos in the same seminar series. Bye-bye.